New channel alert! We just launched a brand new channel called The Amagi 2, where instead of covering anime content, we'll be focusing on live-action movies and TV shows. Our first video will be dropping on Friday. Can we get 10,000 subscribers before then?
The Life of Yuma Isagai, Assassination Classroom. Yuma Isagai is a student in Koro-sensei's Class 3E at Kunugigaoka Junior High School. He's the male class representative. Welcome to the Imagi. In today's video, we're going over the life of Yuma Isagai. Before we begin, we publish a new video every day, so be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. Background. Isagai comes from a poor family. He has an unnamed younger brother and an unnamed younger sister who happen to have the same hair antenna as him and lives with his sick mother. His father died sometime during his first year in middle school, leaving him to take care of his mother and their finances. To keep their expenses from going up, especially from their combined tuition struggles, Isagai began working part-time despite knowing that school regulations stated students weren't allowed to have jobs. He was dropped at Class E because he violated school policy. Out of all the students in Class E who aren't primary perspective characters or primary characters in general, Yuma is among the most seen. While his official introduction wasn't until Chapter 90, his first notable appearance was during the Finals arc where he was the rival of Tepe Araki in Social Studies. Leader Time, Athletic Festival arc. The Athletic Festival arc is where Isagai makes his formal debut. It starts out in Chapter 90 where a few of his classmates are visiting him at his part-time job. While Isagai is attending to two regular customers, they note that he truly is an ikemen, with one of them, most likely Okajima, noting that they want to kill him for it. They then began to basically state how incredible their leader is at everything, and Koro-sensei, who is revealed to have come there for some honey toast, asks them if they're bothered by Isagai no matter how much of an ikemen he is. They say no, and he asks why is that, and Maihara just simply says that Isagai is just a nice guy, earning the agreement of his peers. Then a few more customers come in, who are none other than the Big Five, who found out about Isagai's part-time job. One of the regulars come to Isagai's defense, and Ren Sakagibara charms her and tells her it's a school matter, so they'll take it outside. Outside, Isagai begs Asano to keep it a secret since he needs the part-time job, and Asano states that he would also like to as well, but on one condition. Isagai and the rest of Class E show him their fighting spirit at the Athletic Festival's Botaoshi match. The next day, Class 3E is discussing this and note the unfairness of the entire setup. Isagai, not wanting anything to happen to his companions, states that he'll shoulder all the responsibility. This elicits angry remarks and some students, particularly Karma and Nagisa, throw stuff at him. The class calls him an idiot for thinking he'd be alone in this, and Maihara tells him not to think too much. He slams an anti-sensei knife on Yuma's desk and says it'll be easy beating the nerds in Class A at Botaoshi. Other students then jump in and agree, saying that this match will be a good chance to get back at them for all they've done to them. Isagai is touched by this and declares that they're doing it. It's the day of the athletic festival, and while his classmates are going through their events, Isagai is working on the strategy for the Botaoshi. As Class E show their hidden strengths, Koro-sensei says that if only that unpredictability was used by assassins, and that the foundation of strength, balancing abilities, kinetic vision, and sense, or which have been strengthened through assassinations, will show in non-everyday competitions. He also says that in such ways, those individual personalities become a weapon, and how that will be capitalized in Botaoshi will depend on Isagai. While the students of Class E decide to focus on the final Botaoshi, they find out what Asano had been planning and his true goal, which were in the form of four huge foreign 14 to 15 year old top sportsmen. As Asano is talking to two of them, Isagai starts to feel insecure as his abilities aren't anywhere near Asano's. He starts to feel conflicted and begins worrying about his team. Koro-sensei tells him that in society, there's a limit to one person's abilities, and in terms of the ability to lead and fight with friends, he surpasses even Asano, and even when he falls into a pinch, everyone will fall with him and fight, and that's his personal virtue. Koro-sensei then said that he's glad he was able to be Isagai's homeroom teacher. After that, it's time for the Botaoshi to start, and both teams line up. Class A is given the advantage once again by being allowed to wear headgear and long sleeves. But Class E doesn't let that deter them as they enter their initial formation, the ultimate defense form. Both classes battle it out fiercely during the match. During one particularly tight spot, Isagai thinks back to a previous lesson about Hannibal of Carthage and how he led his small army to victory through wit and thinking outside the box. With that in mind, he leads his team and the Class A students who are chasing them to the stands since there was no rule saying that they had to stay inside the field. Class E continues evading Class A until finally, Muramatsu and Yoshida appear, revealing that being knocked out earlier had been a ploy. Isagai then tells everyone they're done running and calls for the next formation, Speed of Sound. Those of Class E who are on offense rush towards Class A's pole. With all them in, they proceed to corner Class A and shake the pole down. As a last resort, Asano starts attacking and at some point strikes down Isagai, who reveals to have used that to add four more students to the mix. Finally, Isagai calls for their secret weapon, Itona, and launches him 6 feet into the air onto the pole and bringing it down, giving Class E the win. After the match, as everyone is cleaning up, a few underclassmen congratulate Isagai. Eventually, Asano shows up and Maehara asks him if he's going to keep his end of the bargain, to which he states that he doesn't lie, nor use underhanded methods like they did. Isagai comes up and congratulates Asano on his command, and tells him that they should have another match sometime. Asano simply walks off and gives a snide remark, but Isagai isn't bothered by it in the least. While everyone calls him a sore loser, Takebayashi states that Asano has been going through a lot like Isagai, the latter of who says that his situation doesn't even compare. Even so, having everyone together to help him made him grateful that he was poor. After that, Nagisa notes that Isagai isn't flashy like Asano is, nor is he out front or top. He's right there next to them, an assassin and ikemen. The arc then closes with Isagai begging to take home the leftover bread from the bread race. Time to choose. Eventually emerging out as a victor in the battle with Shiro, and after miraculously reviving Kaede from the dead, Koto-sensei collapses due to exhaustion and injuries. With less than half an hour away until Lance of the Heavens, the military space satellite specially constructed to kill Koto-sensei fires its antimatter beam. Koto-sensei addresses Class 3E that the assassin should not miss their dying target, and that the inevitable has come. He further states that all good times must come to an end, hence the classroom. Isagai asks Class 3E whether they should assassinate Koto-sensei by themselves, or to leave him to his fate at the barrel of the satellite battery. All in Class 3E, including himself, choose to assassinate their teacher in his favor so they can maintain their bonds forged with their beloved Koto-sensei as assassins and a target. With everyone holding tentacles, Nagisa volunteered as an executor, and no one in Class E are complaining about it. After graduation, Isagai was shown unable to compute the large reward money they received from the government. Eventually, the class decided to donate some of the money to various organizations. The nursery, being a prime example, used a portion to cover their education and living expenses, and purchased the mountain classroom. The majority of the money was then handed back to the government, with Isagai representing the class. 7 years later, Isagai led some of his former classmates to clean up and renovate their former classroom, finding Kayano there. Isagai also wondered how they'll be able to look after the place once life in general will occupy their time. Personality. Isagai is a kind, cheerful, and reliable person. He's modest, not at all boastful, and helpful. Isagai has been noted to have good leadership qualities and personal virtues, and due to that, he's able to see all the individual strong points in his classmates. Because of these traits, he's considered to be an ikemen, which not only means handsome, but can also imply a flawless personality. However, despite having the personality of a gentleman, Isagai has an extremely casual tone to his speech, often cursing and talking like a regular teenager. Did you enjoy our video? Be sure to check out these other great videos from the Amagi, and make sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.